The death of a 16-year-old domestic worker employed at former Minister Rishad Batyudin's residence earlier this month has shocked the nation and exposed what has long been a common practice in Sri Lanka's more affluent sections of society. Before now, employing young, mainly female domestic workers as cleaners, nannies and kitchen help in households in Colombo and the suburbs has never been viewed as anything more than the fulfillment of a specific need. That need for poverty-stricken families in villages throughout the island to eke out a meager existence in an environment where opportunities are scarce has, however, long overshadowed the need to ensure proper protection of the loved ones they send out into the cities. This is what makes 16-year-old Ishalini's heart-rending tragedy of physical, emotional and sexual exploitation at the hands of the people charged with upholding her rights all the more shocking. Meanwhile, what the police have uncovered so far about the 9 months of her employment at the MP's residence has led to the arrests of MP Batyudin's wife Shihabdin Ayesha, her father Mohammed Shihabdin, her brother Shihabdin Ismat, and one other individual who allegedly brokered Ishalini's employment. The charges being filed against them range from human trafficking to child cruelty, with more expected to be filed as investigations continue, including into almost a dozen other former domestics. Meanwhile, Ishalini's remains were ordered to be exhumed today by the Novarelia Magistrates Court this week for a second post-mortem to be conducted after the initial report concluded that she had been subjected to long-term sexual exploitation. Accordingly, the exhumation was carried out at the Dayagama Cemetery this morning in the presence of a three-member Judicial Medical Committee and Novarelia Magistrate Lushaka Kumari Jayaratna. Her remains were then transported under heavy police car to the Peradeniya Teaching Hospital where the post-mortem is to be conducted. Meanwhile, as protests continue to be held in estate communities, calling for swift justice for those held responsible for Ishalini's death, it remains to be seen what legislative changes will be brought about and whether firm action will be taken to curb what is now increasingly being recognized as an epidemic of systemic abuse of minors in Sri Lanka. However, what is more shocking is that it finally took the death of a young woman with her whole life ahead of her for society to realize that there remains a lot more to be done to protect its most vulnerable members.
දසන කාන්ති චූර්ණයේ සහිත ලිව ආයුෂ් දන්තාලේපය දත්වල ඇති ප්‍රශ්න 10ක් වලකයි.